Okay, hello everybody, and welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition, where I'm going to do some upgrading things. I have most of the potions that I want fully upgraded. I would like to get the Antiven Fire fully upgraded, which I need, apparently I just need Blood Lotus for. So I'm going to go buy a whole crap ton of Blood Lotus, because I have an insane amount of money. But I have Rock Armor fully upgraded to the point where it can stun enemies. I have Tears of the Dead fully upgraded. These ones aren't that important to me. Pitch Grenade's not. Confusion Grenade is fully upgraded. Antiquing Fire is pretty good. I want to get that. I want to get the Shockwave done. So, but I have a bunch of other things that I need for it. So we'll see. We'll see if I have enough. Healing Mist is fully upgraded, which is important. Jar of Bees I don't have yet, but we'll see. It also requires Blood Lotus and a Witherstock apparently, but we'll see about that. And then the health potion I don't have fully upgraded. It requires some Embrium, so I'll see about getting some Embrium. But the regeneration potion is fully upgraded to the point where I can have the proximity heal, which is important. So, yeah, apparently the Crestwood guy sells Crestwood and the Hinterlands Crossroads guy sells it, so we'll just go there. Wow, apparently there's a ton of Red Jenny caches. And she will slightly approve, so maybe I'll have to go through and get some of those. Haven't brought her out in ages. There's a couple in the Hinterlands, apparently, so. Ooh, yeah, let's give you some cool stuff. Oh, she does have cool stuff. Oh, she's all, like, super filled up. Jeez. She's a powerhouse, for sure. Let's give her... So we did. We'll do that for her on that one. Did I fully upgrade? No, I didn't. Let's get these upgraded. Oh, I don't know. Those are all nice. And we did get that one though. But we'll get. Maybe we'll grab that one just so we can fill out her passives here. See, and that increases her armor. Maybe we'll do that one in place of evade, just for kicks. We'll do that, I guess. Maybe, ooh, and the stealth. Let's do that. Okay. What's her... Wow, her dexterity is super high. Cunning, not so much, but wowza. Wowza! Let's buy some stuff.
Are you sure? It's just what I...
Buy lots of Blood Lotus. Alright, about 80.
Restored.
Oh, I do have the garden thingy. Uh-huh. But let's see. Let's see if we can find. Maybe we'll do some Red Jenny stuff. Red Cliff Village. Okay, so let's see.
Well,
so there's Dwarf Sins Past on top of the hill where the Tempter Burns landmark is located. Dwarf Sins Past is over here? No. It's over here. Let's see. Red Cliff Farms. Where's the... Is it down there? Well, one is by the forest camp, apparently. Old Simon's Cave. Where's Dwarfson's Pass? That's the lake, Upper Lake Camp. That's the Red Cliff Camp. There's one at Red Cliff. I don't think that's... It's the outskirts one. Dwarfson's Pass. On top of the hill where the Tempter Burns landmark, so face... Oh, and then face southwest from the landmark. Okay. Top of the hill. Where, that one? Okay.
Word for you.
No! I wish I could get a mod that would get rid of them. I mean, it's kind of useful sometimes if you really need points, but... Did I go into here? Ooh. Sure, why not? Something to sell. Elf root. Yay. I love how it's... Is it going to individually count my blood lotus? Because I got 80 of them. Which way should we go?
Thank you again.
You good? I talked to you, right?
Thank you again.
Yep, okay. I think I got the perk that lets me go quicker. Yeah, wow, I got 8. Jeez. I got the quicker picking grass perk. How'd we get up here? On top of the hill, so not in the cave. How did I even get up there the first time? I do love seeing the Avar monuments scattered around. Old Avar monuments, I believe, anyway, is what they are. Screaming stones. Oh, is it this one? This hill, not this hill that I was circling? Let's see. Wow, I'm so far away. What was I thinking? I was thinking, wow. Just edit all that out, maybe. Ha ha! It would be nice. There it is. It would be nice if during all this, maybe Red Jenny hunting stuff, if we could get some banter going, but, you know, it's the likelihood of that. I'm also, for sure, next time I play, gonna get the mod. I know how to mod Origins, but I'm pretty sure it's a little bit different to mod Inquisition, but I'm definitely gonna get the one that helps trigger banter more often. It doesn't so much trigger banter more often as it goes into the code, because there's like a... Every 15 minutes or so is when banter is supposed to trigger. But basically what happens is every 15 minutes, the game says, should we trigger banter now? And it's like a flip, it's like a coin toss as to whether or not it'll say yes or no. So that's why you can go for so long without hearing any banter sometimes. Is because of that. So, let's see. We face southwest. Never eat sour wheat and go around to the other side of the boulder. Uh-huh.
Worth it, that one. Good find.
Are you gonna approve? You better approve. Oh my gosh, is she not gonna approve, really? Oh good, okay, phew. Okay, this will be worth it then. This will be worth it. Right, the next one's at Red Cliff Village. I'm just gonna go in order so I don't lose track. Red Cliff Village. Walk around the back side of the female merchant's shop. I don't really go into the shops at Red Cliff, but...
We should look around.
Oh, that's right. It's, like, locked. I don't care.
I remember the first time the dead...
I remember the first time the dead walked these lands. Are you the female merchant? Yes, backside of the female merchant shop.
Good time.
That's a fine dwarf. Finding.
I don't even know what I'm getting. I don't even care. It's probably all low level stuff. I've almost maxed out my influence, too. Well, not, I guess not almost, but, you know. 20 is the highest you can get. Old Simeon's Cave. Down here. Wait. By the forest camp. Southwest of the forest camp, just inside to the right. If nothing else, if you guys don't know where these all are, this will be interesting. There's a pair. I thought there was only like 3, but there's a whole list. Whole bunch of them. Southwest. Never eat. Yep, southwest. Ah, there! What am I heading for? Oh, I could pick up this Embrium, too. I tried to buy Embrium, but I do need it. But maybe I'll get a bunch because of my perk. That's right, while I'm running around in the hinterlands, I'll keep an eye out for Embrium. Is this old Simeon's cave? Hi, whoa, hi. Nope, I'm busy. Busy. Oh, Embrium, cool. Whoa! I'm trying to jump. Oh, that didn't quite work. But, you know. Oh, okay, that was not too bad. That was nice. I think Sera just, like, basically exploded it, maybe. Or just Dorian did. Right, never eat. Sweet. What? Spindleweed? I don't think I need spindleweed, but hey, why not? What else? Another bear? Holy crap, I do not have the bear trial on. Why are there more bears everywhere? Is this it? This doesn't look like a cave. Looks like an alcove. How far away is this thing? Do I have it on my map? It's the mercenary fortress. So somewhere around here, maybe? I'll just keep looking. I've never done the mercenary fortress. I think I went there once with Erica, and the whole entire fortress was empty. Done. The least you could do is give me your skin. Yeah, there's the fortress, but this is it? Nope, it's just loot. Thanks. It feels like I'm hunting for shards, but I'm not even hunting for shards. I refuse to hunt for the shards. Apparently it's by the Fade Rift, but I just got attacked by some really snake-looking Mabari. That was terrifying. One of them looks green. That was weird. It's not often we get attacked by Mabari in this game. Oh yeah, apparently we need to go by the Rift. It's, just before the Fade Rift on the right. So maybe over here somewhere. I don't want to activate the rift because I don't freaking care at this point. I keep thinking eventually I'll do a complete playthrough with Erica, like actually complete the game. And then a part of me lately has just sort of quails at the thought. I'm like, I don't know if I want to do that. Oh. Hey, look up! Did I practically get it, like, right on? Because that would be amazing. Or is it just somewhere over here? There's a couple Embryon. Well, come on. Give me, like, a boatload of them. It said it was just to the right, in front of the Fade Rift. Well, not geez. Like, how much into the right? Like, geez. There's a thumbnail for a video that says, make Sera love you. Give her cash. Give her cash. Oh, that's awesome. Like cash spelled like, you know, Red Jenny Cash. That's funny. That's funny. Okay, so apparently the dang net, where is this thing? So this is where the fortress is. That's the tip of it. And it should be in these woods somewhere in here. Did I just completely miss it? Looks like that's where the Fey Drift... Yeah, I must have missed it somehow. You know, Sera, if you could, like, give me, like, a hint. Like, hey, you know, I sense a red Jenny cache. That would be awesome. Doesn't make you elfy. It just, you know... Because I've never been down here, so I can't have found it already. This is not a cave, either. This is technically an alcove. Oh, is it, like, in there, or what? Nope. This is Old Simeon's cave. That's a lootable. Oh, look. So it was just inside.
There we are. Cool. Good find.
Yep, everybody run. We're not gonna worry about it. Not gonna worry about it. Come on. Embryo.
Where do you get all your arrows, Sera?
Yes!
You have hundreds.
From your arse, that's where.
My arse should open up a shop. It's actually quite prolific.
I love Sera and Dorian's relationship. It's really funny. They have a good relationship. Okay, so next we have... So we got all three in the hinterlands. Apparently in Crestwood now is where we should head. We have all the areas opened up, right? Oh, we could do that. Jeez. Crestwood. In the cave that is furthest south of the map. South. Oh, I remember. It's southeast of the dragon. Right? The dragon. Where is the dragon? So, furthest south. Is it that one? Wyvern's Watch. Hmm. It might be, there might be more, but is this Frozen Wyvern statues, lost be- So the dragon is around here. So I think there's a cave over here. In the cave that is furthest south of the map, southeast of the dragon's tower. So this is the dragon's tower, basically. So yeah, it's somewhere over there. Let's just take this, just travel to there, yeah? Yeah, let's just travel there. Wait, no, can I not travel there? Aw, you can't travel to the world travel points? Lame. I'm tempted to do the Astrariums. See, this is the problem with this game, is I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna finish it, and then I'm like, but there are things I wanted to do. I love getting the Astrarium treasures, they're so cool. So cool. Like, the prismatic and chromatic weapons alone are cool. Just wish they'd have put in like a bow and a dagger, you know, like a chromatic prismatic bows and daggers and stuff. Or just one bow and then, like, you know, a set of daggers maybe, or just one dagger. And I wish there were schematics for those because they're so cool. Maybe I know that people can mod in they've modded in weapons for Origins. Like, I got a couple of cool ones. I got one, specifically one, no, I got two. I got the Phoenix Armory, I think, which I can't actually activate because I don't know how to make, it's one of my favorite spots, Zombies versus Plants. I don't know how to make console commands work. I've gone into the code and tried to, you know, mess with exactly what it said to mess with, and it didn't do anything, so now I'm just worried I've messed up my game. Somehow. But yeah, I got the Phoenix Armory and then one other really cool one. I can't remember exactly what it is called, but it's basically just a mage robe and a staff, and it's really cool. Someone told me a trick for this. Apparently it works for all the Astrariums, is that you start on a star that has an odd number of lines coming out of it. So, like, that one's no good. That one's no good. Nope, that one's no good. Well, these ones all look like they have two or four on them. So that's got one. Well, I guess I could start there. That one's got one. So one line coming out of it. So I'll start there. and see how that goes. Well, this one, okay. I mean, this one has three coming out of it. Unless I could somehow come back up and around. Which might be possible. I don't think I've completed this one before. That'd be cool. Cool, let's see how it goes. Yeah, that would be bad. Sweet! Looks like it ripped something in half, maybe? Silentir. Referred to as Silence in the common parlance, the constellation Silentir is historically attributed to Dumat, the god of silence, a leader of the ancient ancient Tevinter pantheon. The depiction of the constellation, however, is often debated. Some depict a dragon in flight, while others, also the most common modern depictions, show a man carrying a horn and a wand. Some scholars believe these represented scales, which would point to this constellation being a supplantation of the elven mythol, but nothing indicates this to be more than speculation. Cool. I've never actually brought Sera and Cassandra out either. They would be a fun little group to bring out, and I need to keep going south. Or just an interesting, cause Sera respects Cassandra. I think Cassandra would eventually get, you know, used to Sarah's ways. Black fence. I do wish, one of the things I really wish they had in Inquisition was a day-night cycle. But there's a lot of things I wish they had, but it is very difficult to do. And I think a lot of times what we don't get to see, because we can complain or we can ask for more things and be like, why wasn't this included? Blah, blah, blah. But we don't see what goes on behind the scenes a lot. Like, I can't remember. There's something, because I watched Mike Laidlaw do live streams. And every now and then he'll mention something, you know, like, because most of the people in the chat are really, really nice. Like, nobody's there to bother him about Dragon Age. Like, there are Dragon Age fans in there, but nobody's there to be like, oh my gosh, what about this? Like, every now and then something will come up and it's, like, funny, you know? Like, a funny thing that's included. And then it's a fun time. He does, like, really cool small indie games or something. Or whatever he feels like doing. But yeah, he mentioned, every now and then he'll mention, like, something like, you know, well, we couldn't do that because of this time constraint or something, you know? Like, or, I can't remember, it's not even time constraint sometimes, it's just, like, little things where it's like, we could do this or that, you know? And I love this staff, I don't care that it's underpowered, like, Dorian, you're gonna be using this staff because it's gorgeous. I don't think I need deep mushroom, I think I have a lot, but we'll just be sure. And I like this, the picking perk. I might have to get that sooner rather than later next time. Lightning rune, nice.
There we are. Yay. Good find.
I think I have been here, actually. Yeah, I got the Overseer cowl from here. And also, there's this, like, alligator skin rug. And that amulet and stuff. Oh, by the way, somebody made beautiful art for me. Some manflesh on Twitter. If I remember, I'll try to link him in the description. But he's made three beautiful pieces of artwork for me, entirely free. Just gifted them to me out of the blue. And I was just stunned and amazed because they're both beautiful. Talon, there's one where Talon's by himself and he looks like a freaking rock star. It's amazing. I love it. And then there's one with Erica and Solas, which just broke my heart because I was like, oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. And they're like so sad looking. And then there's another one with Dorian and Talon being silly. And I freaking loved it. It's so cute. They're so cute. I'll have to show you guys sometime. I really want to show you guys all the art I've got, because I have a lot of really cool art that I didn't make myself, but that I commissioned, and I really, back when I had money, I really enjoyed commissioning artists. And so, but he just gave these to me for free because he was like, do good things, and I was like, oh yeah. It's like, I really value and respect art, so it really blew my mind. And I was just really excited. I'm gonna print them out and hang them up with the rest of my art on my wall. In the Twin Caves, so there's another one in Crestwood. In the Twin Caves, west of the Three Trout Farm Camp, which is... Yes. In the Twin Caves, west of... and across from the Astrarium Cave. Oh, in there? Oh, okay. Because I was like, the only Twin Caves I could think of are the ones that are right next to each other, but they loop. They're exactly the same cave. They just loop around, and there's an entrance and an exit to the cave. So, the Astrarium. But sometimes it's hard to find the Astrarium places, but this one's pretty obvious. Deep Mushroom. Mysterious cave. Approximately halfway in and behind a stalagmite. Just keep scanning for it. Nugs. Well, we are now over approximately halfway. Obsidian's good. I like obsidian. Or is it like halfway, as in the junction? Okay.
Pretty things.
Pretty things. Pretty things. How's my inventory doing? I'm not gonna look. And then, so that's both of them. So next we have the Exalted Plains. Which I feel bad about not completing that mission, but no, you cannot make me. What's that one? Oh, right. Haha, I'm not going there yet. Which is surrounded Enniverus. It's in Enniverus, surrounded by the ruined arches, where one of the Fade Rifts is located near the spot marked by the map of Enniverus. I don't know where Enniverus is. I only have how many landmarks? I only have 7 out of 18 landmarks. Oh shoot, I don't know where it is. Enniverus, Broken Dog. I don't have a lot. None of the camps are marked as Enniverus either. Wow, I did not pick up a lot of... Yeah, Varbrilinaris. Did not pick up a lot of, Demetrius's End. Lindorane's Fall. Alright, time to look up where that one is. I don't have this map of Enniverus. Where is that? I'm looking at the picture of the map, which you can't find the treasure unless you have the map, which I don't really feel like going to get the map. But is it that one area where there is a Fade Rift there, or there was, there's not anymore, but it's like right on the river's edge. I swear I got that one, because you had to get it as part of Silas's apparently the treasure is actually pretty cool too. If I could get, I would be more concerned about getting some of these treasures if I had schematics for them. As it is, if it's not a schematic at this point, I'm like, blah, you know. I'm gonna need to make sure though that I'm gonna try to keep track of like levels and stuff, so when I pick up really cool weapons, I can use them and they'll not just be obsolete next time. And I'll just keep jumping around to all these different areas, like complete the area at a good level and be able to use the weapons and armor that they give me. It just surprised me because Enniverus is very close to Evanurus, you know? Okay, so it is down here somewhere. Over here? Maybe? Wait. I want to just mark it. Just let me mark it. How do I mark it? I was doing it before. Hold up. Wait, no. Oh, dang. I want to go... Exalted Plains. Where's the Dalish shop? There's the Dalish. It's pretty close to the Dalish, apparently, over in... Is it this one? No, it's just above those. Looks like I haven't been there. Have I not been there? Yeah, I haven't been there. Oh, interesting. Well, it is... somewhere... around... there. Oh, I can't... Oh, that's why. I can't mark because I'm not there. That's right. Let's travel there. We'll see if this works, because I'm not going to compromise. Part of the thing that people don't like about Inquisition either was that you can say one thing to one companion to make them happy, and then you can say something else completely different to another companion, like, that completely goes against, you know, everything you've said before, you know, just to make them happy. And a lot of people didn't like that there wasn't consequences for your conversational directions, you know, like, that you could just lie or you could just say whatever you wanted just to make them happy. Freaking, I also looked up a mod to see if I could wear Sera's armor. There is a mod to let you wear Sera's armor, only if you're human. Because Sera can only wear human armors, and it made me so sad, but that's the way it is, so I guess I'll have to live with it. Like, the people who do mods, they were trying to explain why it's that way. It's because, I mean, Sera, you can't mess with the individual race body mesh so much. So it's difficult to make armors for one, like, it's near impossible to make armors for one species fit another species or race or whatever. So, yeah, it was really sad because I would love to put my elf in Sera's armor because I love Sera's armor. It's so nice. I love it. Okay, so now that we're here, we can put a little dillywop down right there. I don't think we raided the Unadin Grotto. I think we gave the guy the key so that we could get the scout or get the Dalish elf agent. I think I've gotten all the agents. I tried looking it up. I think the only one I can think of that I don't have is the guy who's possibly a noble from the Emerald Graves. But yeah. I really do love the Exalted Plains. It's a beautiful, stark area. Like, you can see, like, bits and pieces of what it used to be, you know? But I also think, I mean, I think the rock stuff is beautiful, too, like the rock formations. Where? No, cease and desist. What are you getting angry about? We're not attacking any Hala. Dang it. Okay. Is it that one? Let's see. I think it's might be a little further up. Or something. Or is this actually, no. I think this is Enniverus, but this is telling me where the map, the treasure is. No, that doesn't make any sense. Oh, okay, so it looks like it's actually in the ancient baths, not here. I think this was where the map leads you, which you can get apparently from Victory Rise in the barracks under Victory Rise, which we've seen. They're part of the ramparts that are scattered throughout the Exalted Plains. I like the scope of the Exalted Plains. Like, you can just all of a sudden stumble upon these wide battlefields that have been used for battle for, like, millennia, it seems like. Come on, give me Fade Touched Obsidian. That's the good stuff. Have I not been here? I swear I've been in here. Apparently not. I have, because I lit that up. Well, what are you doing here, guy? You're dead.
Goodbye.
Cool bow. I feel like this bow is very solid, you know? a freaking shield that takes 10 years. Oh, are you dead? Oh, okay, good, that hit him. I was worried. So Sera has something that gives her guard too. I didn't realize. Apparently it's just inside somewhere. It's just inside the ruins, it looks like. Right where we are. So it should be down this hallway somewhere. No? Might be further in. We'll check. No harm in checking if I haven't already been here. I swear you had to come here, though, for part of the... Yeah, because we bashed in the wall. Okay. So we did. Yeah, and I looted that. Yeah. And we came for that. I think I must be in, like... Oopsie. I must be in, like, the wrong... area? I'm, like, watching this YouTube video now. Looks like the only one that I can, that he's obviously showing is the one, that house is still on fire, is one that's further down here. Ooh, we could get some Snoofler skin. Nope, I did not want to antagonize that guy in there. I wanted to loot this guy. Thank you, Cassandra, for just going to town on that guy. Snoofler skin! Yeah, get our priorities straight. Screw those guys in there. We're gonna kill the snooflers. Okay. Nice. Embryum! So I think that the map might be in there for the one. But I don't know. I'm not gonna worry about it. But I know I recognize the ruins he was at. They're down here by this rift down here. And I'm just gonna run in, because that, like I said, that is the one that spawns the revenant, so. Oh yeah. Not really sure what all those notes, if they actually do anything or not. Oh, so here it is. I guess if we went in there, we could find the map. I'm not worried about it. Apparently you get something called Cleaver, a big two-handed weapon, I assume. From that treasure. More Snoop and a very. Okay, so it's an area, not like a, it's like a region, not just the ruins. Red Jenny Cash, quick!
Fine.
Everybody out!
Worth
everybody
something,
out!
I bet.
Everybody out. We are not fighting a remnant right now. Probably could take it, and it wouldn't be a problem, but not gonna worry about it. Okay, let's see. Yeah, there's one. So that is the Anniverse, so that was where we were, and then there's the one by the Riverside Garrison. Which I believe is right there. We can travel to, well, the fence camp is inside of it. Well, inside this little area, but we'll just go there. Sera slightly approves. Frick yeah, if this doesn't work, I'm gonna be like so upset though. So it's outside, behind the wall with the stairs, down to the fade rip is a large rock, behind the rock is a cache. Okay, so we just need to go over here. I don't know if I want to get involved with that, though, because that, like, you have to, like, free it or something. So we can go to the Emprise and the Emerald Graves. Oops. So let's, oh, we can't travel yet, because I activated. Yay. Let's just not be worried about it. So let's go to the Empress really quick. It's right outside, or it's in the... on the wooden walkway in the Sarnia Quarry near the landmark. Sarnia. Where's the quarry? Tower Camp. Let's keep. Deep Rose. It's the Sarnia Camp. That's our main camp. But it's on the wooden walkway in the Sarnia Quarry near the landmark. Where did we put the... So that's inside of a thing. Veliska's Watch. Quarry's over here? Yeah, apparently it's... Okay, it's close to the Sarnia Quarry landmark. It's so weird to me that we're, like, building stuff around the Red Lyrium when it's supposed to be, like, the deadliest thing ever. It still weirds me out. I mean, it looks cool, but we really shouldn't be building right next to it. Near this quarry and land, the quarry landmark. Oh crap! Oh, this is cool. I didn't know this was here. Little secret walkway. That's cool.
Ooh, what a good bit.
Whoa! Cool. That's cool. Oh, and it leads you right to the keep. Nice, I did not realize that. That's good to know. Because otherwise it's a pain in the butt to try to find the keep. Right, we'll do one more. I might have already gotten this one. I think this was the first one I ever found. It's in the Emerald Graves. Near the Bear Cave. Yeah. I think. Giant's Cave. To the... Oh, no, it's not. Okay, Giant's Cave to the southwest. Of Southfinger Tower and just north of Malathan's Tree landmark. Oh, okay, so where all these landmarks are. Oh, okay, so in there. Alright then. Let's travel to Dinan Hunting. I'm surprised I haven't enough room for all this stuff. I did not leave myself much room to go, you know, treasure hunting. I just realized, though, Sera's armor fits in with our, basically fits in with our current color scheme, silver and black. Silver, black, and white. It's kind of a grayish blue and white, but it fits. Remember with Erica, I ended up bringing Sera around a lot towards the end. Like, I brought her out a lot in Jaws of a Con, and her and Blackwall were hilarious. And then I brought her out in Trespasser 2. And I enjoyed every second of it. She was pretty hilarious. It was just, I was a very elfy elf, and so we just didn't get along. And Talon isn't even that elfy of an elf. He is not, like, super, like, loud and proud about it. He's just, oh, crap. Oh, wow, look at that. I slid right into it. I did not even realize. Cool. Nice. Oh, crap. There's a giant right there. How nice. This was the cave I first found the Red Jenny stuff, the Red Jenny cash in, like, ever. Found out it was a thing. And yeah, we've already been here. Okay, well, good to know. Let's go back home. Let's see if it did any difference. And if nothing else, there's one more we could do, but I doubt that that would do much. You know. Oh man, I should flirt with Scout Harding, apparently. While Sarah's in the party. Well, let's go see. If nothing else, I'll upgrade my potions. I think our armor is pretty good at this point. There's really nothing much to be done.
I see.
For the armor.
I saw him just walking free.
That was a decision, and it was well considered.
After what he did,
I knew many killed in war. Sadly, in a game of power decided by heirs, only one target matters.
You're a cold prick. You know that.
Wait, no, no. This floor, we want to be on this floor.
Yeah. There's you, yes.
I'll be back if I need you.
Go on.
Apparently we have a fairly high approval with her, but because that apparently that well, those that sort of phrase fine. Indicates that she's got a fairly high approval.
What do you need?
Like, there's you again. And she bids the Inquisitor farewell with a go on. But that's also the neutral stuff, too. Like...
Could be better.
Let me see. Hang on, let me go back and bother her again.
Love seeing you, yeah?
Love seeing you, yeah. That's apparently a warm, friendly greeting.
I'll be back if I need you.
Go on.
I don't know. I might not be able to ever be. We might not be buddies in this one. Dang it. That frustrates me. Would that I could. It's so difficult to get her approval if you're a freaking elf. And if you do anything to, you know, be like, well, hey, maybe the elves aren't that bad. She's like, no. It's like, I know you had a hard time. I know you had a hard time in the past, but geez. Too bad I don't have any judgments, or I would judge something and do something that maybe she would like. I don't know. And all the things in the hinterlands that we could have done to gain her approval, we've already done. Ugh, that frustrates me. Yay! I got an achievement! I'm amazing! Those ones are good. We wanted to do increase the damage, increase their duration, increase that. Yes, oh yes, we did it! Oh, hallelujah. We do jar bees. Well, we're out of Imbrium. We don't have wither stock. Oh, we're out of Blood Lotus now, too. Oh, well. Well, we get increased the panic chance. Healing Mist, Antiphon Fire, Confusion Grenade's good, Pitch Grenade. Could do that, maybe. Probably not have enough for it, to be honest. Yeah. Don't have enough of everything, but... Well, that's cool. Let's make sure we're all equipped then. Dang, I wish I What is the belt that I have on currently? Belt. I have the Master Belt of Focus. I could. So what do I want? I want grenades, potions, or tonics. Which one do I want? Grenades. So the grenade is the fire. I do want. Yeah, let's do. Let's do the grenade. belt. Oh, I have both of them? Oh, cool. Well, alright then. We'll get all those. And then we have... We bring Dorian. So he's good. And we'll give him more of that. Cassandra, get you all good to go. So she's got a jar of bees and the healing mist. And who else would I bring? Me, Cassandra, Dorian. Who do I bring? Well, I can't remember who I bring. Jeez. Well, I'll definitely have to check on like the last couple of videos. Who did I bring to the thing? Well, I think I brought Solas with me to the temple because I wanted to bring him, you know. But anyway, I'll look into it. But thank you guys. This is probably not the most exciting thing, and it was kind of a waste of time, turns out. But I appreciate it. Hopefully next time we'll get going on the actual mission. So thank you again. I appreciate it. I will see you in the next one.